Previously on 1000.
King of Spades. Very mysterious, very magical type of fellow.
But the clear leader here is all the little character dudes interacting with the pips.
The time has finally come, the Tuck case. I'm a little bit intimidated, built this part of the project up really big in my head.
I can't even tell you how long I was just staring at a blank white template, feeling completely lost.
I'm just looking at it and I'm like, is it right? I feel like I'm just doing it over and over and over again, and it's just like not working.
I think any artist can tell you that pressure is a double-edged sword. The pressure to be great can motivate you and push you forward, but too much pressure can stop you dead in your tracks.
Am I overproducing it? Am I overthinking it? Am I way too inside of my own head? Yes, definitely so. Have I hyped this project up way too big inside of my head? For sure.
It's just really shocking how difficult this Tuck case has been.
Your boy is just stumbling blind through the wilderness of the Tuck case, trying to figure out what the hell's going on. I think once again, I'm just gonna freaking start over from scratch. God. Playing cards video number 6, baby. Oh, look at this hoodie. Look at this hoodie. In these videos, I like to order stupid stuff off of Amazon that has to do with playing cards. But come on, yo. Like, did you just go and get a 200 pixel JPEG off of Google image searches and be like, we're gonna put this on Amazon? Just makes me appreciate the high quality merch over on 1000art.com. Bing. Anyway, for those of you that have been following this series, you know that this is the part of the video where I check out some of the feedback that you guys left me. We need a theme song. I made a video. You guys responded. Let's check out what you said. The polls. This time I had two polls. The first one was about the card back options. Coming in last place is the blue tones only on the card back. Second place goes to the colorful card back. And the first place is the monochromatic card back, navy blue only, which is what I was personally leaning towards. The second poll, I asked about the tuck case options. So coming in last place was the first version of the second design. Then coming in at 10% was the first design, which I didn't even finish in the video. I did not like that one. Next one at 11% was the second design with the dark version. And then the absolute dominant clear winner was the last design that I did that also had that die cut sleeve that you slid on. I wanted to highlight this comment from Ron Hickerson. He said, here is a peasant pip idea. Ron said, it would be fun for the peasants in each suit to reflect their personality of their lieges. Something like the hearts would be suitors slash courtship, the clubs would be soldiers, the diamonds would be bards slash minstrels, and the spades would be wizards and mages. Dude, Ron, I am gonna just straight up steal your idea word for word. This is so dope. Ron, shoot me an email, man. I'm just jacking your idea, so I feel like I should send you a free deck of cards. Reach out to me, bro. Another really interesting idea from one of my patrons. He goes by Dub Shorts on Patreon. He sent me this super rough sketch. He said, what if when the cards were lined up in a certain way, the little characters interacting with the pips stretched across this full grid? And I love that. I love the idea of, you know, when you look at something in a little bit of a different way, maybe not the way that it's initially intended, a new story shows itself. And I think this is a fantastic idea. I'm stealing that too. Dub Shorts, hit me up, bro. You get a free deck of cards. Jack and I ideas on this episode. And then I wanted to highlight a comment from JFA. He said, keep the Joker secret. We have to buy the cards to see the art. JFA, bro, you are a freaking marketing genius, man. Keep the Joker secret and you have to buy the deck to find out what art I actually did. I really, really like this idea. Not just because it's like really good marketing, but through this video series, you guys have seen every single intimate detail of every single decision I'm making, every single piece of art that I'm making. And there won't really be some kind of element of surprise when you buy the deck. And I think it'll be really fun and really exciting that when you do open that deck for the first time, you can rush over to the Jokers and be like, okay, this is the one piece of art that I don't know what it is. I don't know what to expect. Jay, Love your idea. Hit me up, bro. I'll get you a free deck. Now, there's one more thing I wanted to talk about. Something that could have unintentionally been a major misstep with my deck. And that has to do with the King of Spades. Now, this is my King of Spades, and I drew this character as a black guy. And when I released the video about this, I got a message from somebody that said, hey, 1000, I just wanted to bring your attention to something which you might not be aware of. In like the 1910s or the 1920s, the term spade became like a racially derogatory term for black people. And the fact that you depicted your King of Spades as a black person could be seen by some as like kind of weird. And I was like, whoa, like I've never heard that term before in my life. I've never heard somebody refer to a black person in that way. I've never even seen it in like movies or historical depictions of anything. Like it was 100% news to me. And I was like, oh, that certainly wasn't my intention. And I was kind of thinking like, well, that's one single email. I was like, maybe that's just like a random one-off person. Then I got a second email, and in total I got two emails and one DM about it. And I was like, man, this is a bummer. I think people will know that like I'm depicting a black person here as a regal, powerful king, and I think people who watch my content would know that that is 100% not my intention in any way to like put anybody down or be derogatory towards anyone or have any kind of hateful feelings about anyone based on their race or culture or any of that stuff. And even though I only got like three total emails out of like tens of thousands of people who have been commenting and watching and enjoying this series, that doesn't mean that there wasn't more people who are like thinking that it was a little bit weird just because they didn't take the time to email me, or maybe they were a little bit intimidated to email me about a sensitive subject like that, doesn't mean that other people out there weren't feeling the same way. So I think I need to change my King of Spades. So the first simplest solution would be to just like change my King of Spades, maybe even just change the face so it's not like black features. But like, it seems more messed up to me to like just delete this character than to like figure something else out. So I took this King of Spades and made a few changes, and now he has become the King of Hearts. And then I spent the past 2 days making this new King of Spades, and I think he's looking really super cool. And my current King of Hearts that I had before is kind of one of my most meh characters that I've drawn. He was one of the first characters that I drew, and I feel like as I've progressed through this project, my characters have gotten better and better and better. I don't think he was anybody's favorite character, so the fact that he's getting dethroned, I don't know if it's gonna really annoy anyone. So if we bring in the new King of Hearts, bring this guy down here, bring in the new King of Hearts, and then the new King of Spades. Cool. So that would be the change. Let me know what you think about the changes. I'd especially be interested to hear some of the thoughts of some of my black fans and followers. So that's that. Anyway, I'm really, really excited to try out some of these new ideas that you guys gave me for the actual number cards with all these little characters interacting with the pips and the indices. And I think it's gonna be a pretty big project. So no time like the present. Let's jump into this art. So on Dub Shorts' concept sketch, he has them laid out in like a 3x3 grid, but he forgot that my 10 cards are already special cards, so my grid can't be like that. So I've laid my cards out in a 4x2 grid, 2 through 5, 4 through 9. That way I can draw all my little characters kind of stretching across a grid like this. When I started the number cards, I thought they were gonna be pretty easy because the illustrations are a lot more simple than the court cards. But trying to connect each of these illustrations across this grid I've set up while keeping them within the theme of their individual kingdoms proved to be a little bit more tricky and time-consuming than I initially thought. So I just got kind of a disappointing email. My plan was to print the cards with the United States Playing Card Company and then send those printed cards over to this other company because they're gonna do the specialized tuck case for me. But they just now let me know that they only work with people if they print the cards for them, if they do the case for them, if they do the assembly for them, and they do the order fulfillment for them, which up until this point, I didn't know that at all. All I wanted these guys for was my tuck case. So I emailed this other company back and I was like, I don't want full project management.
Like, let me know if you guys can move forward on this project with me. And now I'm just waiting to hear back, but that's a huge bummer. I'm a little bit annoyed. I don't know if I'm annoyed with myself for not communicating better. I don't know if I'm annoyed with them for not just saying straight off the bat, like, hey, this is how it works. Do I need to somehow find another company that can do these crazy sleeves for me? Do I need to abandon the sleeve idea? Roadblock. Major roadblock. What am I gonna do? All right, folks, I have completed the number cards. What a gauntlet. Super excited to show you guys. But first, I've been trying to figure out this tuck case situation. I've been emailing companies and talking on the phone with companies, and I think I'm gonna go in a different direction with the company that's gonna produce my tuck case. I got a hold of this one company and they were like, yo, let's jump on the phone. Let's talk through your whole project. They gave me like so much detail, so much information. They gave me super transparent pricing. They gave me every single option laid out. And I think they're gonna do a super good job on my tuck case. So we got that figured out. But onto the number cards. Okay, the first one that I did was the hearts. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit. That's kind of a close up on the two. There's a bit of a close up on the three. Here's the four and the five. This guy's got a whole pile of love letters going. The love archer is the six. Got this guy sawing from the seven. Got this guy writing a love song on the eight. And the archer from the six is shooting love arrows into the nine. Next one I did was my clubs. We got the warrior suit. This brings me back to when I was a kid. I used to draw these like super complex drawings of like all these knights like storming a castle. It was totally Where's Waldo vibe. And once that I started drawing these like medieval warriors, I was just transported back to like third grade. But the two is like the actual castle. The number three is the knight of the club's kingdom. Number four is this catapult shooting the castle on the number two card. Number five, bro. You know, war ain't pretty. On the sixth card, we have this crossbowman. The three and the seven are kind of connected by this like grappling hook thing, lifting one of the pips. And then this soldier is like lugging the pip. The eight, we have this like gauntlet with a sword. And then the number nine, we got the one soldier who's just like getting drunk, slacking off. So those are my clubs. Then we got the diamonds. So we have bards and minstrels and musicians. We've got this fair maiden reading a story, magical powers coming out of her book. We've got this like Shakespearean actor. Instead of holding a skull, he's holding one of the diamonds. Watcher guys, musician guy chilling on the beanstalk. You've got this kind of writer. This is kind of like a semi half self portrait. You could see this guy is like me spending hours and hours designing all these dang cards with my little quill. Got another little musician guy. He's so emo. He's just like writing all those love songs for all those ladies. The seven card, the actual like pips are the leaves growing off of the beanstalk. I thought that was kind of cool. The eight card is like this sort of hero character climbing up the beanstalk. And the nine card and the five card, like all the pages from this like writer or artist are dropping down onto the nine card. And then finally, we have the spades. The spades are like the magic. On the number two, we got the spooky skull. The six card has this witch like boiling her cauldron, and the smoke from the six is going like up through the two, passing through the eye sockets of the skull over to the number three. Number three, we have this like kind of warlock wizard who's fighting this like ugly troll. The troll has one of the pips like gonna hurl it at this wizard guy, so they're in like an epic mythological battle. The five card, we have these little elves. The elves are like the little worker dudes of this kingdom, and they're like going from the nine up to the five on these like planks of wood doing their little worker job. One other little thing is like the elves are the workers, and they're going from nine to five, so like when you do your work, you like work nine to five. So I thought that was kind of a fun little Easter egg in there. Yeah, the six is the witch. The seven is this like giant basilisk snake in an epic battle with this like Gandalf Merlin
demon looking wizard. But that's my spades cards. When we go back to my file where I have like all the cards together, look at how much of the deck we have done now. Oh my goodness. I'm kind of thinking when I do these uncut sheets, I want the grids to line up. I made this kind of like janky little grid here to kind of figure out how I was gonna lay my cards out. So it'd be like ace of spades, king of spades, queen of spades, jack of spades. And then normally it would be like 10, 9, 8, 7, but on mine it would go ace of diamonds, king of diamonds, queen of diamonds, jack of diamonds. So that way 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 would be together. And that would be the little spades grid there. And then on the diamonds, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that would be the diamonds grid there. Then it would be like the clubs and the hearts. And then down at the bottom, it would be like the 10, because the 10s are special because it's the 10 Hun deck. 10 of spades, 10 of diamonds, 10 of clubs, 10 of hearts. Then it would be joker, joker, add card, add card. So very kind of strange order, but for the uncut sheets to like look the most epic, I think that's how I have to do it. And I don't think that USPCC is gonna print my uncut sheets one way and then do my actual decks another way. I haven't actually talked to them about it. I'm just assuming that like the uncut sheets are literally uncut sheets. Like they're gonna print them the exact same as all the rest of my decks of cards. They just won't cut them. So it's gonna be a funky order, but I think that's gonna be cool. When you hang that on your wall, you wanna see the grid together. So the Vivid Kingdoms deck is coming together. All I have left to do is my Joker's card, which I think we're gonna keep a secret, and then my two add cards, and then like little tweaks and changes before I like send stuff off. I'm thinking for one of my add cards, like with my Jack of Spades here, he's holding the 10 card, so it's like a 10 card reveal. So I think that magicians could do a cool trick where like they get you to like choose the 10 card, right? And then they're like, oh, is this your card, whatever? And they're like, wait a second, what is that Jack of Spades holding? Is that your card? And then you're like, oh, that's my card. But I think in order for it to work like really well, there needs to be like a duplicate of the Jack of Spades. And I just put like the actual card back on there. So then that way, through some magicianry, sleight of hand stuff, they could swap out the Jack of Spades that's like holding the back of the cards and then reveal the 10 of Spades. All that magic stuff, like you magicians can like figure out how to do that. You probably already know how to do that. I have no idea how to do that, but I figured like there's a trick in there somewhere. You magician, shoot a video of that when the cards come out, because I really want to see it in action, but I'm just like thinking that would be cool in my head. But the other add card, I have no idea what to do so far. Maybe something meaningful to me, maybe something meaningful to this community. If you guys have any suggestions, definitely let me know. I've been asking my patrons if they have suggestions. They've given me some really cool suggestions, but it's getting really close. I think the next video that comes out is gonna be me announcing that the Kickstarter is like happening and walking you through the Kickstarter process a little bit. So the cards will finally be available to like pre-order. Dang, this doesn't even feel, it just feels like it's been such a journey doing this deck of cards. There's like so many tiny little details to think about. I've learned so much through this whole process. And yeah, I guess that's it. Thank you so much to my patrons. You guys are the coolest people on the internet. Behind the scenes on our private Discord server, you guys have been giving me so many good suggestions. You've been helping me out so much on this project. It's really cool to be able to just bounce ideas off of you guys real time. Thank you, patrons. All right, y'all, I'm 1000. The playing card saga continues. We're almost there. See you guys on the next one. I'm 1000. Peace out. Oh!